So now I'd like to introduce Dr. Morishita of Osaka University's Graduate School of Medicine and founder of ENGIS, a bioventure from Osaka University. It was the first to put its name in the hat in developing a new corona vaccine here in Japan. And although it has more recently become famous for its vaccine development for the coronavirus, ENGIS was in the limelight in 2019 for being the first Japanese manufacturer to get approval and sell a gene therapy product. It was a very, very difficult thing to finally get, and up until that point. And at a press conference at the time, Dr. Morishita said, "It's been 20 years since ENGIS was founded. It's been a long time in the making, but I'm very happy to be finally able to deliver the product to our patients." So today's keynote speech will be given by Dr. Morishita, who is a pioneer of university-launched ventures and is entitled Hub for Ventures and Research Institutes, Osaka Area. He will talk about the appeal of Osaka as an innovation city where world-class technologies, industries, and markets are concentrated. He will also maybe talk a little bit about the future possibilities for Expo 2025. And if we're really lucky, we'll be able to get some interesting stories, such as ENGIS's efforts in the fight against the coronavirus. So now, without further ado, let me introduce the keynote speech by Dr. Ryuichi Morishita, Professor of Clinical Gene Therapy, Graduate School of Medicine, Osaka University. Dr. Morishita, if you're ready, please take the floor.
Okay, thank you very much for your kind introductions. I'm Ryuichi Morishita, Osaka University. Today, I'm very happy to share our data and also the future potential for Expo 2025. So please see the my slide. Actually, Osaka is a very famous and also very popular for the many research institutes and also universities. For example, Osaka University, my university, is located on the central of Osaka and also very near to Kobe and Kyoto National University. And in addition to that, these famous biotech national university and also national institute are located in Osaka areas. For example, the site near Osaka University, National Institute of Biomedical Innovation was located there. And also the National Cerebral and Cardiovascular Center was located in the same areas. So together with the national and private university and also the national and private research institute in Kansai areas, the now Kansai is very common for the biotech clusters. Actually, the biotech cluster Kansai areas is one of the most biggest biocluster in the world also in the Asia. These kind of biotech cluster has been started from the almost 200 or 300 years ago. The initially Koa Ogata, the very famous doctor, started Tekijuku. So Tekijuku was original Osaka University, Ama University, and he was a pioneer for the modern medicine in Japan. Actually, he build up the Tekijuku near to Doshomachi. Doshomachi is a very famous wholesaler for Japanese and Chinese herbal medicine in Edo periods. And currently still many global pharmaceutical companies located in Doshomachi areas, including Takeda, Mitsubishi Tanabe, Shionogi, Danipon Sumitomo, Ono, and so on. So therefore, Osaka Kansai areas is very unique character for the biotech areas. Especially Osaka areas has successful to build up the new biocluster, so-called site bioclusters. The site is very located near Osaka University, and Osaka Prefecture started to build up the site biocluster 20 years ago. And currently, site biocluster one of the biggest biocluster in Japan and in the Asia. So here is the site life science park site of bioclusters. As you see, Osaka University here and also Expo 70 Memorial Park in here. This is a very famous Taiyo no To, the Sun's Tower. So this is the monorail way, and the site area is located here. In site areas, there are three different kinds of research incubators, and also near site areas, National Cerebral and Cardiac Center, Riken Quantitative Biological Center, and Center for Information and Neural Network, Osaka University itself, and Hospital 2. So here is one of the big research institute in Saito, the so-called National Institute of Biomedical Innovation, NIBIOS. So this center is specific to study the innovative drugs for the unmet medical needs. So this is a NIBIO, and also there are many kinds of research buildings and facilities in science areas. The currently already all spaces are occupied at these cells. In site areas, three independent incubator facilities. So first one is a site bio incubator, and second one, site bio innovation center, and also site bio hills center. So among these three incubation centers, there are many startup bio ventures, and also the spin-off from university, and also spin-off from the pharmaceutical companies. So this site research area is supported by local government for rental support and also facility support. The tenant of an institution is now almost full. So started from the initially, the occupation rate is not so high, but year by year, there are many pharmaceutical biotechs located here, and currently occupation rate is being close to 100%. Actually, from site research areas, there are several public companies which went to the IPO market, Mothers, and also Nasdaq, and also the others. For example, Anges went to the Tokyo Mothers IPO market 2002. I mentioned that a little bit later. And also the last year, Fanpage also and Kringer went to the IPO market as in Tokyo Mothers. And also Soiken and other company, STEM Rims went to the IPO market too. So now site areas is one of the many innovative and also the many popular areas of biotech fields. So from now, I want to mention a little bit Andes corporate profiles. So Andes was founded in 1999 by myself as a biotech spin-off from the Osaka University. Actually, Andes was first IPO biotech in September 2002 in Tokyo stock market. Currently, market cap is about $1.5 billion. The one of the biggest biotech in Japan. So Andes have developed three different kinds of genetic medicine with unique platforms. So HGF gene therapy drugs, Coratagens, was launched in last year, in 2019. And also Andes have developed NF-kappa B decoy oligonucleotide. And also now Andes is very famous for the development of the DNA vaccine to treat COVID-19. So together with this unique character, Andes is still very unique and also charming companies. So actually several media mentioned the Andes movement. For example, 2003, Financial Times mentioned Japan biotech technology pioneer moves out of the doghouse. So initially, Andes was located in the research areas of the Ministry of Industry. And 2003, ANGIS moved to the site research parks. So their financial terms mentioned this kind of way. And also 2003, Little Thomas have announced ANGIS is located top five in growing rate in Asia. Actually top in the life science. The current platform technology of ANGIS is DNA, plasmid DNA technologies. So initially we applied this technology to stimulate therapeutic angiogenesis to treat diabetic ischemic ulcer using hepatocyte growth factor HGF genes. So later we applied plasmid DNA technology for the DNA vaccine. So DNA vaccine is very unique technology because DNA vaccine only require simple needle and syringe injections and also induce both T cell and B cell mediated antibody response. And also plasmid DNA is well known for the very high safety profiles. Currently, no immunological response and also no severe adverse effect has been known. So here is the appearance of our first gene therapy drugs, Coragen. So Coragen was the first gene therapy drug in Japan and also first plasmid DNA gene therapy drug in the world. So Coragen was around 2019, 2 years ago, by Japanese government. The cost is fully covered by public healthcare reimbursement. One vial is around $5,500. Total cost is around $1.2 million to $1.8 million. $1,000. So Coragen is a plasmid DNA gene therapy coding human hepatocyte growth factor HGF gene driven cytobine megalos by promoters. Coragen gene therapy induces H production in the muscle cell around the injection site and enhance neovascularizations. Already I mentioned Coragen was conditional approval in Japan on 2019 and launched in 2019 September. The current company has ongoing United States phase 3B studies. And Coragen was sold by the Mitsubishi Tanabe in Japan and the US. And also we have a cooperator in Israel named Kamada. So after the success of a Coragen launchment, the company have tried DNA vaccine using same platform technologies. The company have now developed angiotensin II DNA vaccine. This product is a combination of a plasmid DNA encoding angiotensin II hepatitis B virus core protein fusion and angiotensin II conjugating peptide. So this product increases anti-angiotensin II antibody and suppressed blood pressures. And this blood pressure lowering effect by angiotensin II DNA vaccine was sustained for at least 6 months after vaccinations. So ANGIS already finished phase 1-2 study in Australia. The recently ANGIS announced the data. We are very happy to see the increase in anti-angiotensin II antibody in the patient who received angiotensin II DNA vaccine. So currently ANGIS have plans next phase 2 study to treat hypertension patient. So during the development of a hypertension DNA vaccines, as you know, COVID-19 is a pandemic. So therefore, we tried to apply this technology to develop DNA vaccine for COVID-19. So already WHO vaccine guideline mentioned advantage over DNA vaccines. For example, DNA vaccine is rapid cloning and testing in animal for antiviral immunity, and also DNA vaccines can induce neutralizing antibody and T-cell response to injure viral cell. And especially DNA vaccine has extensive human safety database. And currently, no immune response against the plasmid vector was known. And also, DNA vaccine is not necessary to handle no pathogen or mammalian tissues. So using these technologies, Osaka University, our groups, and Andes have started DNA vaccine for COVID-19. Then this project was collaborated with Takara Bio for plasmid manufacturing, and also Dicel Corporations for their proprietary needleless jet injectors. Takara Bio located in Shiga, near to the Osaka, and also Dicel was located in Osaka. So this is some kind of Osaka developed vaccine for COVID-19. So this project was founded from MHLW Health and Labor Science Research Grant and also AMEDO. Already we have finished two phase 1-2 study in Japan, started from the June 2020. And currently we are doing phase 2B/3 clinical trial in Tokyo and Osaka areas. Here is these clinical trials. The first one is a non-randomized, open-label, non-controlled phase 1/2 study to assess safety and immunogenicity of two doses of intramuscular AG0301 COVID-19 in healthy adult. So this trial have a test, low dosage 1 mg twice at 2 weeks interval versus high dosage 2 mg twice at 2 weeks intervals. And the second phase 1-2 clinical trial is so named a randomized open label non-controlled phase 1/2 study to assess safety immunogenicity of twice or three times dosing of intramuscular AG032 COVID-19 in healthy adult. In this trial, we have tested 2 mg twice at 2 weeks intervals, 2 mg twice at 4 weeks intervals, 2 weeks three times at 2 weeks intervals groups. And all two studies have demonstrated good safety profile of our DNA vaccine. And we also obtained very good result for antigenicity using this AG0302 COVID-19 DNA vaccine. So therefore, now we have started phase 2/3 clinical trials, a randomized double-blind placebo controlled phase 2/3 study to assess safety and immunogenicity of a twice dosing of intramuscular AG0302 COVID-19 in healthy adult. So in this trial, we have two arms. One arm is 2 mg twice at 2 weeks interval versus placebo. And the second arm is 2 mg twice at 4 weeks interval versus placebo. So totally 500 patients were recruited in these trials. So currently this trial ongoing, we will obtain result probably on this spring. So after this trial, we will move to the global phase 3 clinical trial, enrolling 30 or 40,000 volunteers, including Japan and Asian country too. So hopefully we will launch DNA vaccine for COVID-19 very soon. So in addition to the intramuscular injection DNA vaccine, we also attempted intradermal injectors developed by Dicels. Using this device, we hope that DNA vaccine amount was decreased to 1/5 or 1/10, so allowing us to supply the 10 million or 20 million dosage for the COVID-19 DNA vaccine. So this trial is designed as open label dose escalation study in healthy adult. So currently DNA vaccine was developed by all Japan structures. Osaka University and spin-off ANGES have controlled over this project. And Takara Bio is responsible for manufacturing and mass productions. Together with AGC, Asahi Glass Corporation, Shionogi Pharma, and Kaneka. And also Peptide Research Institution, FarmPep, EPS, SNBL Future, and other many companies have collaborated in this project. And also, already as mentioned, Dicel have developed injector device. And this project was fully covered by the Japan government, including AMEDO. And Osaka City, as well as the Osaka Prefecture, have a very good collaborative way for this development of a DNA vaccine for the clinical trial. As you see, the most of a company was located Osaka, Kansai areas. Actually, in this, we are very happy located in Osaka, Kansai areas. Therefore, we can develop DNA vaccine together with these very good and very helpful collaborators. So now I want to move to the talk of Expo 2025. Actually, before the corona, the Osaka Prefecture and Osaka City and Japan government have decided their main theme, designing future society for our lives. Actually, we are not sure for the coronavirus at this point. However, the theme is very good after the corona. The sub-theme is how to lead a healthy life in diverse manner, as well as sustainable socio-economic systems. So Expo 2025 will be started from April to October 2025. And the government and Osaka Prefecture and the city estimated probably projected visitor is around close to 30 million people. Actually, Expo 2025 focus on three lives: saving lives, empowering lives, connecting lives. And especially Expo 2025 is very critical for the achievement of SDGs. And also its key is Society 5.0. And also Expo 2025, it's a venue for co-creations. So Japan government and Osaka local government have tried to emphasize co-creation among company, government, university, and also general peoples. So in the Osaka 2025, Osaka City and Prefecture decided to make Osaka pavilions. The main theme is Reborn, Umare Kawari. So Mayor Matsui many times mentioned that this is Osaka Healthcare Pavilions. This is one of the idea for the appearance of Osaka Pavilion Reborn. So this pavilion image the egg. So probably this is an egg for the Reborn for future our lives. Especially on this Monday, I was appointed as a general director of the Osaka Pavilion Reborn. So I'm very happy to be responsible for this Osaka pavilions. The currently, we have a committee for the promotion Osaka pavilions. And already we are discussing about the some potential for the venue of the Osaka pavilions. I think that one of a very good trial to make the Voyager for 10 years younger. If you will ride on these machines, you may be measured for the blood vessel life, brain life, skin life, heart life, and so on. After that, if you want to make your own age to be 10 years younger, you may choose supplement, food, and also exercise according to the AI measurement of the apri. And if you choose, for example, skin aging to become 10 years younger, the pavilion will provide device or food and exercise supplement for becoming your skin 10 years younger. So we want to make these kind of anti-aging pavilions for your 10 years younger. And in addition to the anti-aging areas, now we are planning to make AI-based future hospitals. So currently we want to make some legacy for this Osaka Healthcare Pavilions. Actually, from this year, Virtual Osaka Expo will be opened in the open areas via internet. If you enter to these pavilions, you may become an avatar. Your avatar will be 10 years older or 10 years younger for your daily lives. So hopefully you may be enjoyed in Virtual Osaka Expo very soon. So at the last, I wanted to introduce promotion video for Expo 2025. So this is very unique videos. Please enjoy.
Today, the world is giving its all to resolve global issues. Japan has been contributing to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals of the 2030 Agenda with its advanced technology and the culture of co-creation. Expo Osaka Kansai will be an opportunity to expand the community of co-creation to the world. Our vision. People's Living Lab. The World Expo will be a living lab where we try new ideas for the future society for all humanity.
Create something entirely new.
Turn impossible into possible.
Bring different types of happiness to people. bring change to the world.
Combine diverse thinking and approaches.
Explore new possibilities.
Cherish curiosity.
Challenge yourself.
Don't be afraid of failure.
No matter where they are from, what values they hold, all people are equal creators here. The Expo encourages everyone to try new ideas and will be the perfect place for trial and error. The Expo is an opportunity where seemingly unrelated talents and ideas meet and new ideas are generated. Our strategy. Expo Osaka Kansai is not just an event that happens in 2025. It is a 7-year project of continued trial and error, starting on the day of the host city selection. Expo Osaka Kansai's legacy will be more than just tangible things like buildings and infrastructure. It is a change in people's minds. It will shape our future society by influencing individuals throughout their lifetimes. Expo Osaka Kansai does not aim to produce a single correct answer. It will motivate each of the world's 10 billion people to think, experiment, and act. Our future. Well, let's try and imagine the future we are striving forward. In the year 2025, Tomomi, a high school student, is inspired by the Expo and goes on to study regenerative medicine at university. Ali left his company to start his own AI-based advanced nursing care business in a special economic zone set up during the Expo. Max used prize money from an Expo competition to develop technology that revitalized agriculture in his country. Tanya, a retired engineer, teaches programming to children she met at the Expo. Expo Osaka Kansai does not end in 2025. It is just the beginning. The changes we catalyze will carry on into 2026 and beyond. Because Japan has been open to new ideas and developing new technologies to contribute to achieve SDGs. And because Osaka and Kansai is a place brimming with vitality that exceeds the ordinary and no matter what the challenge, maintains an enthusiastic, well, get to it then attitude. Expo Osaka Kansai will offer the entire world a place to experiment and shape our future society. People's Living Lab. Expo 2025, Osaka, Kansai, Japan.
Okay, thank you for your attention. Actually, I'm very happy to meet all of you at Expo 2025. Thank you very much again.